What is Hashimoto's disease? I'm Dr. Hagmeyer, and today I want to talk about what Hashimoto's disease is. Maybe you've just been diagnosed with Hashimoto's disease, or maybe you took one of the quizzes on my website and now you're searching for some answers. This video that I put together for you is important because there's a huge misunderstanding and really just a disconnect between doctors and patients when it comes to this disease and how it's treated in conventional medicine. Today's video, I wanna cover exactly what's happening with Hashimoto's, what doctors don't tell you, and really why taking thyroid medication does not fix this problem. So Hashimoto's disease goes by a few different names. Sometimes it's called Hashimoto's thyroiditis. Sometimes it's called chronic lymphocytic thyroiditis. Sometimes it's called autoimmune thyroid disease. Now, regardless of what we call it, Hashimoto's disease is an autoimmune disease. In fact, it's the number one cause of hypothyroidism or underactive thyroid worldwide. Now, that's an important distinction to understand and remember. In conventional medicine, you are put on thyroid medication like Synthroid or Levothyroxine because your thyroid hormones are low. But the underlying problem is not the thyroid. Now, in some people, Hashimoto's can obviously cause symptoms associated with hypothyroidism, but it can also cause symptoms associated with hyperthyroidism or an overactive thyroid. This is where you start losing weight, you experience heart palpitations, you start getting hot flashes, you're losing your hair, you're feeling on edge, you're feeling wired and jittery. And with Hashimoto's disease, your immune system doesn't like your thyroid. It sees it as a threat to the body. It sees it as an invader. So the immune system does what it's supposed to do anytime an intruder enters the body, and that is it starts attacking the thyroid gland, and its main goal is, of course, to destroy the intruder. Now, your thyroid gland is a small butterfly-shaped gland that sits at the base of your neck. And in people with Hashimoto's disease, what happens is your immune system has started making antibodies, thyroid peroxidase and thyroglobulin antibodies. And it's these antibodies that tell us that your immune system is attacking the thyroid gland. And once this attack gets underway, large numbers of immune system fighting cells called lymphocytes, they build up in the thyroid gland. And this is why many times with people with Hashimoto's, we call it chronic lymphocytic thyroiditis. The thyroiditis part tells us that there's inflammation in the thyroid gland. And because of this inflammation and the buildup of these lymphocytes, the thyroid gland becomes enlarged. It begins to affect the way you breathe, the way you swallow. Sometimes it affects things like there's always something, you feel like there's something always caught in your throat. Sometimes you're feeling thyroid nodules or you have an enlargement of the thyroid gland called a goiter. Now, when your immune system attacks and damages the thyroid gland enough, obviously your thyroid gland stops making thyroid hormones. And obviously when your thyroid can't make enough thyroid hormones like T3 and T4, you start to have problems with metabolism, meaning how your body converts food into energy. And as a result, no matter how much you diet, how much you exercise, you continue to gain weight. You continue to feel cold all the time. Maybe you develop all kinds of gastrointestinal problems like irritable bowel syndrome or small intestinal bacterial overgrowth or acid reflux or gallbladder problems, right? It can begin to affect your brain, causing things like brain fog and trouble focusing and concentration. Maybe you start experiencing irritability, depression, anxiety that you never had before. Other symptoms include things like headaches or migraines, where you might find yourself having trouble falling asleep or staying asleep. You might feel on edge. Again, you feel jittery. But that's not all Hashimoto's can affect. Many patients start to feel problems in their chest. Patients often feel like their heart is racing or it stops beating. What you're really feeling are heart palpitations, which again are very, very common in Hashimoto's disease. On blood work, you may see things like high cholesterol, high blood sugar. Your doctor may diagnose you with type 2 diabetes. You may see elevated liver enzymes. Your doctor may diagnose you with anemia or B12 deficiency. Now, believe it or not, those are just some of the more common symptoms of Hashimoto's, but there are some lesser known symptoms of Hashimoto's that you should also be aware of. Now, I won't go into those too much today, but I did an entire video on the overlooked symptoms of Hashimoto's. And so if that's something you want to know more about those kinds of symptoms, again, check out the video that I did on that particular topic. Again, I'll leave a link in the description box as far as that goes. But if you've stumbled on this video, be sure to check out my YouTube channel because there are tons of videos that I put together for people that are searching for answers and looking for more information. If you visit my website, make sure you download my free thyroid guide. There's tons of great information in that guide that talks about thyroid testing, optimal ranges for different thyroid markers. I talk about the different patterns of thyroid disease, like low T3, thyroid resistance, thyroid overconversion, and things that you can do to start jump-starting that thyroid gland. Now, if you have Hashimoto's, there's one thing I want you to take away from today's video, and here it is. And this is really just the single most important thing that your doctor is probably just going to gloss over and not discuss with you. Hashimoto's disease is not a thyroid problem. The end result is a thyroid problem, but the root cause is an immune system issue. The real solution to understanding this is trying to understand why your immune system is attacking the thyroid gland in the first place. And number two, what can be done to calm down the immune system and bring balance back to the immune system so it doesn't keep destroying the thyroid gland or, in some case, start attacking other parts of the body. Now, those are two areas that an endocrinologist and your general practitioner is not going to be very interested in. These doctors are going to keep chasing this immune system problem with thyroid medications. And what that means is they're going to change your dosages. They're going to change the kind of thyroid medication you're taking. That means they're going to be prescribing all kinds of new medications to treat all the new symptoms that begin because you're not addressing the root cause. It seems like no one wants to ask the question like, why is my immune system attacking my thyroid gland? And the fact is once your immune system starts eating away at the thyroid gland, it's then going to turn on other tissues of the body. And this is why we almost always see patients that have Hashimoto's disease within several years, 5 to 10 years, they have other autoimmune diseases. Maybe they have pernicious anemia. Maybe they have rheumatoid arthritis. Maybe they get diagnosed with lupus or Sjogren's. Maybe they get diagnosed with celiac disease or Addison's disease. So again, the focus needs to be what's triggering the autoimmune attack, and number two, how do we stabilize it? If your doctor is not addressing these questions or thinking about it from this viewpoint, your doctor is just managing your disease. And so what should you do if you've been recently diagnosed with Hashimoto's? Well, number one is acknowledge that you need more help than your traditional medicine doctor can ever offer you. Number two, start working with a doctor who specializes in functional medicine, in addition to your endocrinologist or general practitioner. It's not an either or, it's not one or the other. Your GP or endocrinologist will never look at the triggers of autoimmunity. They'll never look at how your diet is influencing your immune system. They'll never look at how your nutrition, your gut, your sex hormones. So again, the point I tell you about this is look for a doctor certified in functional medicine. So as we wrap up today's video, I want to hear from you. Tell me some of the most frustrating thyroid symptoms that you've been struggling with. What's been your experience with your doctors up to this point in time? What's been your treatment? And can you relate to any of the things that I've talked about in today's video? And again, if there's a topic pertaining to the thyroid or pertaining to the immune system that you want to know more about, drop me a line in the comment section below, and it might be a topic for an upcoming video. Otherwise, check out the description box for a list of videos that I've already done. Okay, well, that's going to wrap up today's video. Take care.